Dear students, good morning to one and all. The second unit, structural organization in plants morphology. The chapter 5th, morphology of flowering plants. Dear students, previous classes we detailedly discussed about the how many types of root systems are present in angiospermic plants, what are the functions of root systems, and how many regions are present in tip of the root. Now we are going to discuss about the modifications of root. So dear students, so most of the years in this question to be asked in IPE pattern, that is 8 marks question or long answer type of question. This question is very important. So that is named define root modification, explain how is modified to root system, perform in different types of functions, or another type, define root systems, how many types of root systems, how many types of root modifications are present in angiospermic plant, right to any 6 root modifications. So okay, now first, what is meaning of root modification? But first discuss about what is meaning of root. So dear students, the part of the plant body is present below the soil, that is called root. In generally, the angiospermic plant body consists of mainly 2 parts. First one, root system. Second one, shoot system or stem. Dear students, first, what is the meaning of root system or root? The part of the plant body present below the soil or underground, that is called root system or root. Next one, what is the meaning of shoot system or stem? The part of the plant body present above the soil or area, that is called shoot system or stem. Shoot system or stem. So this is root system and shoot system. Okay, now next coming to what is meaning of modifications of root. So dear students, roots in some plants, roots, this is a tap root system, this is a fibrous root system, this is a adventitious root system. In generally, the angiospermic plant to be present of mainly 3 types of root systems. The first one, tap root system. Second one, fibrous root system. Third one, adventitious root system. Okay, now so roots in some plants change. Roots in some plants, roots, tap roots, fibrous roots, adventitious roots. Roots in some plants, carrot, radish, beetroot, or turnip, asparagus, and sweet potato. Roots in some plants change in their shape and structure. change in their root shape, root structure, and become formed different functions other than absorption of water and mineral nutrients. They performed specific functions, that is storage of food material and respiration and fixed atmospheric nitrogen. These modifications are named as modifications of root or root modifications. Okay, no? Clearly understood. Once again, repeated to the what is meaning of modifications of root or root modifications. Roots in some plants change in their shape and structure and perform different functions other than absorption of water and mineral nutrients, but they performed a specific functions, that is storage of food materials and respiration or breathing and fixed atmospheric nitrogen, that is called modifications of root or root modifications. This is a definition. In generally, what are the functions of root system? Mainly the primary function, the root systems, tap root system, either fibrous root system, either advanced root systems, sometimes mainly absorption of water and mineral nutrients from the soil. This is a main function. Next function are here, sometimes some of the plant roots to be stored of food materials, that is storage roots or tuberous roots. And sometimes in some plants of the roots, proper anchorage to the plant pods are to be providing a mechanical support, that is named prop roots and stilt roots. And in some plants, generally the root is always synthesized to be plant growth regulators such as auxins, gibberellins and cytokinins. These are the main functions of the root systems. Okay, now. So, next, how many types of root modifications? So, dear students, 8 types of root modifications are here. They are namely, first one, storage roots or tuberous roots. Second one, prop roots or pillar roots. Third one, stilt roots. Fourth one, respiratory roots or nematophores. Fifth one, velamic roots or epiphytic roots. Sixth one, parasitic roots or astorial roots. Seventh one, nodular roots. Eighth one, photosynthetic roots. These are 8 types of root modifications or 8 types of modifications of roots. So what are the given examples for 8 types of root modifications? Now the first root modification, that is storage roots or tuberous roots, given the example for carrot, radish, turnip and asparagus and sweet potato. These are examples for स्टोरेज रूट्स आर ट्यूबरस रूट्स. सेकंड रूट मॉडिफिकेशन प्रॉप रूट्स आर पिलर रूट्स. एग्जांपल फॉर बनी एंड ट्री. नेक्स्ट थर्ड रूट मॉडिफिकेशन स्टिल्ट रूट्स. गिवन द एग्जांपल फॉर मेज एंड शुगर केन. नेक्स्ट फोर्थ रूट मॉडिफिकेशन रेस्पिरेटरी रूट्स आर नेमेटोफोर्स. गिवन द एग्जांपल फॉर राइजोपोरा एंड एविसिनिया. नेक्स्ट फिफ्थ रूट मॉडिफिकेशंस आर हियर वेलामिन रूट्स आर एपिफाइटिक रूट्स. गिवन द एग्जांपल फॉर वांडा. नेक्स्ट सिक्स्थ रूट मॉडिफिकेशन पैरासाइटिक रूट्स आर ऑस्टोरियल रूट्स. गिवन द एग्जांपल फॉर स्ट्राइगा एंड विस्कम एंड कस्कुटा एंड रफ्लेशिया. नेक्स्ट सेवेंथ रूट मॉडिफिकेशन आर हियर नॉडुलर रूट्स. गिवन द एग्जांपल फॉर ग्राउंड नट सोयाबीन groundnut and soya bean as well as gram nuts especially in the Fabaceae family members. Next eighth root modification are here photosynthetic roots. Given the example for here theophyllum. These are the examples for types of root modifications or modifications of roots. Okay now, so today we are going to discuss about the first type of root modification, that is storage roots or tuberous roots. In this storage roots or tuberous roots are observed in different types of root systems and in different types of angiospermic plants. So in different types of root systems such as tap root system, given the example for here carrot, radish, beetroot. Next fibrous root system, given the examples for here asparagus, that is shatamuli. And next one third adventitious root system, given the example for here sweet potato, that is hypomea. Okay now, so dear students, in some plants of roots is always stored food materials, these roots are called storage roots. In some plant roots, especially carrot plant root, radish plant root, beetroot plant root, asparagus plant root, sweet potato plant root. In some plants, roots are stored food materials in the future purpose. These roots are called storage roots. So these storage roots become swollen. Or tuberous-like structure. Why? Because due to the storage of food materials or accumulation of food materials, these roots are also called tuberous roots. Okay now, once again, in some plants roots are stored food materials for their future purpose. These roots are called storage roots. Especially all biennial plants be store of food, food material to be future purpose, to be future purpose. So in these plants, store of food materials then become swollen or tuberous like structure. So hence these roots are called tuberous roots. Tuberous roots. Storage roots are also known as tuberous roots. Why? Because so these root systems are prepared one tuber like structure by means become swollen due to storage of food materials or accumulation of food materials. Okay, now so next discuss about the some of the tap root systems and fibrous root systems and adventitious root systems. So dear students, especially this is a carrot, this is a radish, this is a beetroot. So these plants are having two tap root systems. Carrot, radish, beetroot. In those three plants containing taproot systems. Taproot system constitute within the primary root system and surrounded by lateral roots. That is secondary and tertiary roots. Secondary and tertiary roots. So this is a primary root and this is a secondary root. These are tertiary roots. That is known as taproot system. In majority of dicotyledon plants, the direct elongation of the radicle grows into the soil. Then after, so this developed to primary root. So this primary root, in order to several branches referred to as secondary and tertiary roots. Finally, the primary root and lateral branches constitute within the taproot system. Constitute within the taproot system. So, dear students, so in this taproot system of carrot and radish and beetroot to be stored food material, so hence appeared to be tuberous like structures. Okay, now by means taproot system in carrot, radish and beetroot is always stored food materials that to be appeared tuberous like structure. So in generally the taproot system of carrot to be appeared conical in shape. This is a conical in shape. Taproot system in radish to be appeared spindle in shape. Spindle in shape. Taproot system in beetroot to be appeared top in shape. Top in shape. So this type of taproot systems are present in different shapes. Okay, now carrot to be present of conical in shape. Radish to be presence of spindle in shape. Beetroot to be presence of top in shape. Top in shape. So these are different types of root systems. Especially in some of the biennial plants. Biennial plants. By means some of the plants lifespan is completed only 2 years. Only 2 years. That is called biennial. Especially like carrot, radish, beetroot. These plants lifespan is completed only 2 years. That is called biennial plants. So in biennial plants of carrot, radish, beetroot to be presents special adaptation, that is storage roots or tuberous roots. Okay now.
So dear students, this is a carrot, this is a radish, this is a beetroot. So this is a primary root system. So this is a secondary root and surrounded by tertiary roots.
Okay now.
So these roots are always developed below the soil or underground the soil, not developed above the soil. This is very very important. In generally, most of the plants are bearing fruits above the soil. By means bearing the fruits is always aerial part of the plants. But here, in some of the plant roots is also modified specific types of fruits. That is modifications of roots. By means some plants of roots is also to be appeared fruit-like structures, fruit-like structures. But these fruit-like structures of roots only appeared below the soil, only underground part of the soil, not appeared above the soil or aerial part of the branches. So in some plants of taproot system, in some plants of fibrous root system, in some plants of advanced root system is also modified to fruit-like structures. But these are not fruits, one type of storage roots or tuberous roots. Okay now. Next coming to in some plants of fibrous roots, especially asparagus, is also to be storage of food materials. So to be appeared one cluster like structure, to be appeared one cluster like structures, to be appeared tuberous like structures, but these are tubers are related to one cluster. That is asparagus. In asparagus plants, fibrous root system is also modified to storage roots or tuberous roots. So dear students, generally these are fibrous roots. Fibrous roots are to be appeared generally air-like structure or fiber-like structures. But here, these fibrous roots are air-like structure of roots or storage of food material. So hence to be appeared a smaller tuberous-like structure. So these are arranged in cluster in shape. These are arranged in cluster in shape. So that is known as storage roots or tuberous roots. Storage roots or tuberous roots. Given the examples for here, asparagus. Dear students, this is a asparagus. These are fibrous roots. So these fibrous roots are modified to storage roots. By means fibrous roots is also stored food materials. Become future purpose. Next coming to advanced roots. So taproot systems and fibrous root systems. So these two types of root systems only developed below the soil or underground part of the soil. But here another type of root system, that is advanced root system. So advanced root system is also developed not below the soil, is always above the soil. By means aerial part of the branches, aerial part of the branches. So some plants are banyan tree. So these advanced roots are developed to larger branches. In some plants of maize and sugarcane, these advanced roots are developed to lower node of the stems. But these advanced roots are not absorption of water and mineral nutrients. Only the main function are here is always providing a mechanical support given the plants. Is always providing a mechanical support given the plants. But here in some plants, especially sweet potato, that is Ipomoea. So some of the advanced roots are developed to node of the stem. So a node of the stem to be present to a single sweet potato. A single node is always to be present of a single sweet potato. Okay now. So a
single node of the stem to be presents a single sweet potato or a single hypomea. So that is named advanced root. That is named advanced root. So this advanced roots is also to be presents of storage roots or tuberous roots. Tuberous roots. Okay, no? By means sweet potato or hypomea, the advanced roots is also modified to storage roots or fibrous storage roots or tuberous roots. Storage roots or tuberous roots. Dear students, in top root systems, especially carrot, radish, turnip. So these plants, especially in all those of mother plants, would be produced is always only one carrot, only one radish, only one beetroot. By means a single mother plant is always produced a single carrot, a single radish, a single beetroot. But here a single asparagus plant to be produced several storage roots or several tuberous roots. Why? Because this is a fibrous root system. So this fibrous root system containing several secondary tertiary roots. By means primary root is short-lived, is replaced by large number of roots are produced. So these large number of roots, every large number of roots to become modified storage roots. So hence several storage roots or tuberous roots are present in asparagus plant. And next coming to sweet potato. The sweet potato containing several storage roots and several tuberous roots, but here based on the node of the stem, if one stem containing 4 nodes, so to be present of how many storage roots? 4 storage roots. Why? Because one stem containing 4 nodes, so therefore each node to be produced one storage root or one sweet potato. So hence 4 nodes equal to 4 sweet potato or 4 storage roots. Okay, now this is a first root modification, that is now storage roots or tuberous roots. Okay, now thank you.